Hi, my name is Richard. Today my topic is vertical integration. So let's dive into the topic. So vertical integration. Vertical integration is a strategy that many companies use to gain control over the industry's value chain. This strategy is one of the major considerations when developing corporate level strategy. The important question in corporate strategy is whether the company should participate in one activity or many activities along the industry value chain. For example, the company has to decide if it only manufactures products or engage in retailing and after sales services as well. Two issues have to consider before integration. Cost. An organization should vertically integrate when cost of making the product inside the company are lower than the cost of buying and the product in the market. Scope of the frame. A frame should consider whether moving into industries will not dilute its current competencies. New activities in the company are also harder to manage and control. The answers to previous question determine if the company will pursue none, partial or full. 6. Definitions. Vertical integration is a strategy used by a company to gain control over its suppliers or distributors in order to increase the firm's power in the marketplace, reduce transaction costs, and secure supplies or distribution channels. Forward integration is a strategy where the firm gains ownership or increase control over its previous customers, distributors or retailers. Backward integration is a strategy where a firm gains ownership or increased control over its previous suppliers. Difference between horizontal and vertical and horizontal integrations. Vertical integration is different from horizontal integration, where a corporate usually acquires or merges with a competitor in the same industry. An example of horizontal integration would be a company competing in raw materials industry and buying another company in the same industry rather than trying to expand to entertainment goods industry. Re-merges with a competitor in the same industry. Require horizontal or integration where a corporate usually acquires or merges with a competitor in the same industry. An example of horizontal integration would be company competing in raw materials industry and buying another company in the same industry rather than trying to expand intermediate goods industry. Raw materials, entertainment goods, from B, from C, horizontal integration and vertical integration. Types of vertical integration. Firms can pursue forward, backward or balanced big strategies. Raw materials, entertainment goods, manufacturing, marketing, sales, after sales services, forward integration, backward integration, balanced integration. Different from horizontal integration, where a corporate usually acquires and merges with a competitor in the same industry. The example of horizontal integration would be a company competing in the raw materials industry. Forward integration. If the manufacturing company engages in sales or after sales industries, it pursues forward integration strategy. This strategy is implemented when the company wants to achieve higher economics of scale and larger market share. Forward integration strategy become very popular with increasing internet appearance. Many manufacturing companies have built their own online stores and started selling their products directly to consumers bypassing retailers. The strategy is implemented when the company wants to achieve higher economics of scale and larger market share. Forward integration strategy became very popular with increasing internet appearance. Many manufacturing companies have their built online stores and started selling their products directly to consumers by passing retailers. The manufacturing company engages in sales after sales industries with its purchases for our integration strategy. Our integration strategy is effective when few quality distributors are available in the industry. Distributors or retailers have high profit margins. Distributors are very expensive, unreliable, or unable to meet firm's distribution needs. The industry is expected to grow significantly. There are benefits of stable production and distribution. The company has enough resources and capabilities to manage the new business. Distributors or retailers have high profit margins. The industry is expected to grow significantly. Few quality distributors are available in the industry. There are benefits of stable production and distribution. The company has enough resources and capabilities to manage the new business. Backward integration. When the same manufacturing company starts making intermediate goods for itself or takes over its previous supplier, it pursues backward integration strategy. Firms implement backward integration strategy in order to secure table input of resources and become more efficient. Backward integration strategy is most beneficial when firm's current suppliers are unreliable, expensive, or cannot supply the required inputs. There are only few small suppliers, but many few competitors in the industry. The industry is expanding rapidly. The price of inputs are unstable. Suppliers earn high profit margins. A company has necessary resources and capabilities to manage new business. Balanced integration strategy is simply a combination of forward and backward integration. Advantages of the strategy: lower cost due to eliminated market transition costs, improved quality of supplies, critical resources can be acquired to be seen. With vertical integration, improved coordination in supply chain, greater market share, secure distribution channels, facilities investment in specialization assets, no comparisons. Disadvantages: higher costs if the company is incapable to manage new activities efficiently. The ownership of supply and distribution channels may lead to lower quality of products, reduced efficiency because of lack of competition, increased bureaucracy, high investments leads to reduced flexibility, higher potential for legal repercussion due to size. An organization may become a monopoly. New competencies may clash with old ones and lead to competitive disadvantage. Alternatives to vertical integration: the strategy may not allow always to be the best choice for an organization due to lack of sufficient resources that are needed to venture into a new industry. Sometimes the alternatives to vertical integration offer more benefits. Valuable choice depends on the amount of investments required and integration level. For example, short-term contract require little integration, much less investment than joint ventures. Joint ventures, more integration, long-term contracts, licensing, and short-term contract. Purchase market transition, less integration. Thank you for this topic.